Hey guys, this is Sarah Zaster from the Daily De-Stress blog, How to Manage Farm Stress. As we head into spring, that to-do list gets longer and longer. And I know if you're like me, at the end of the day, kind of especially as spring happens and we're outside for longer hours, we're working harder physically, it takes a toll on our bodies. It's super easy to overdo it in the spring and then we end up paying for it for days and maybe even a week later. So this week's video is 7 ways to ease soreness after you have worked hard first thing in the spring. So first off, after you come in from a long day, make sure you take a nice relaxing shower, a bath, whatever works for you here. But take some time, give yourself some time to relax. Maybe this is after you put the kids to bed, but make sure that you give yourself enough time to let those muscles relax and then stretch. Stretch out those muscles. Stretch your shoulders, your arms, your legs, your back. Make sure you get your neck in there too so that those muscles can loosen up because it will help you to sleep a lot better. When we work harder, our muscles take the brunt of that and then we don't always sleep well. The next thing you can do is give yourself a little massage, and whether you use a big foam roller or those muscle rollers that you can get anywhere, that's a great thing to do to loosen up some soreness, relax those muscles, and it helps to break up the any lactic acid buildup that we have, which decreases the soreness that we feel after those long, hard days. The next thing you can do, this is one of my favorites. We call it legs up the wall. And what you do is you literally lay up next to a wall and put your legs up the wall. Okay. It's super easy. You can do it on the floor in your bed, but basically you just scoot your hips so that they're about a foot away from the wall and then rest those feet up on the wall with your knees slightly bent. You can do this from anywhere for a minute to 5 minutes until it, if it doesn't feel comfortable anymore, go ahead and bring those legs down. It's a great way to help decrease that fight or flight response, helps your parasympathetic nervous system kick into action, and it feels so, so good, okay? The next thing you need to make sure you're doing is drinking plenty of water. As our physical activity increases, our need for water does as well. But when we are busy in the springtime, that doesn't always happen. So make sure that you're drinking plenty of water, especially if it's not hot outside. We don't necessarily feel thirsty, so it's easy to get dehydrated. Number 6, make sure that you're getting enough sleep. It's difficult to sleep in sometimes, but going to bed early is my favorite kind of trick around this. So make sure you're getting plenty of sleep, 8 hours at minimum, to make sure that you're giving your body proper time to fix all of those, to help our body feel restored and heal at night. Number 7 is to keep moving. When we're sore, when we're feeling the stress, it's easy to just lay on the couch and do nothing, especially if we kind of overdid it the day before, but make sure you keep that body moving because it will actually decrease your soreness over the long term. Okay. I love this video topic because it's kind of where my two worlds of wellness and farming meet. Okay. So after those long, hard days in the spring, make sure that you're taking care of your body to decrease soreness that you feel after those spring chores are done. You guys have a great week and we'll see you later. Bye.